I have trained 1,000 artificial intelligence soldiers to fight against 1,000 special AI units. The reason why these new units are so special, because you are the ones who came up with this idea and made me do this. It's all your fault. In the previous episode of Epic AI Wars, I've announced a contest where you could submit your unit ideas on my Discord channel. There have been lots of cool ideas that would help us further break even more Geneva Convention rules, such as, but not limited to, flamethrower, because ain't nothing better than the smell of napalm in the morning. Sudoku Bomber, you can figure this one yourself. Or, Craig. Yeah, you don't wanna mess up with Craig. Despite all these cool options, there was one devil that stood out the most. One that gathered almost 3 times as many votes as other submissions on average. One that will send shivers down your spine. Meet the Frenchman. Damn. I'm giving up. A Frenchman? Really? Even the engineer got less votes and by a decent margin. Oh my god. Alright, let's see what does it say about his abilities. The Frenchman is an offensive troop with a big boy baguette and a croissant grenade. His main attack is the baguette, which deals the same amount of damage as a warrior, but has a special ability. The Frenchman can eat part of the baguette to regain all his health back, however, his attack will get smaller because the baguette is smaller. His secondary attack is the grenade throw that deals area damage. Well, sound just like an OP warrior, but let's try. Before we get to the training, there are some small changes I made to the simulation. Warriors got nerfed and now they deal 50 damage per hit instead of 100 which used to be before. Musketeers got nerfed as well, having their damage lowered from 50 to 25, but also with a lower attack speed. Before, musketeers would attack once every 2 seconds, and this time has been doubled, resulting in one attack every 4 seconds. For our first fight, we'll have Frenchmen in Team Blue fight against Musketeers and Warriors from Team Red. I have turned off the friendly fire for all units and started training them as always in the mosh pit. Here the agents have a better chance at hitting their opponents, thus learning the rules of the game much quicker. And since friendly fire was turned off, the Frenchmen were able to throw the croissant grenade right under their feet without worrying about hurting themselves or their teammates. This would result in 90% of Team Red being unalived right off the bat in the first seconds of the round. After 5 rounds of French domination in the mosh pit, it was time to split the two teams apart, red team on the right of the map and blue team on the left. And that is where the situation changed drastically. While Frenchman grenades could not reach their opponents, musketeers were feeling like fish in the water, getting better and better with each round. You can also immediately see a difference in warriors and Frenchman strategies. Frenchmen are grouped all together waiting for the opponents to get closer, while the warriors are actively scouting the area and pushing in all directions looking for their prey. About 15 rounds in, and warriors have already sensed the smell of fear, allowing them to push like a team towards the scared Frenchman. But there ain't anything more dangerous than a cornered animal, resulting in this massacre. I let them train overnight and oh boy, Team Red managed to win more than 200 times, annihilating the Frenchman with each round, and just look at these formations. While warriors and Frenchmen are fighting tooth and nail in the middle of the map, musketeers are arranging themselves in some sort of arc formation, supporting their teammates from afar. This is definitely looking cool, but I doubt this would work as efficient if the friendly fire was turned on, since they would most probably just shoot down all their allies. Well, instead of guessing, I decided to try it out. Same environment, same teams, but this time, friendly fire for both teams is active. Oh damn, I forgot about the grenades. More than 90% of the entire population gets wiped in the first few seconds by the grenade barrage, while the last survivors are trying to fight each other despite the concussion. Yeah, well, I kept training them for an entire day and this is the result. Wow, with this kind of teammates, who even needs enemies? In the first second, 99% of Team Blue was wiped by friendly fire from grenades, leaving about 5 survivors to struggle against an entire army of warriors and musketeers. Some tried to hide in the garbage bins, some tried to hide in the cafe, but the Red Army was marching without hesitation. Seeing this, our poor traumatized Frenchmen even tried to run away, perhaps to warn their friends about the terrors that happened here, but eventually they got caught by the warriors, and these dudes take no hostages. So smash that like and subscribe button right now if you don't want to be on their naughty list. Well, I guess the moral of the round is don't give dum-dums dangerous toys unless you want them to blow themselves up. With explosives, I mean. If we have friendly fire on, the Frenchmen will annihilate themselves. But if we have it turned off, the musketeers will hunt them down. So what if we try Frenchmen against warriors only and without any friendly fire? This time there was much more back and forth during the training rounds, Team Blue securing the first two victories, but then I guess Team Red switched some strategies and they started winning. After splitting the two teams apart, once again it was the warriors who kept pushing towards their enemies, and on round 70 the Frenchmen even managed to win one more round. I was feeling positive about the results and left them train overnight, and after about 50 hours of training, here is the final result. 1000 Frenchmen will be fighting against 1000 warriors. Pause this video right now and let me know in the comments who is gonna win, Team Blue or Team Red. The war starts. All the warriors are advancing forward while Team Blue seems to be clustering closer together, getting ready for the attack, but it seems they're retreating? Yeah, they're definitely running away. There haven't been any casualties yet, but the Frenchmen are already retreating and running for their lives. You could say that the French surrendered without a fight. Anyways, the warriors managed to catch up, slicing through enemy team like a red hot knife through a light bulb. Looks like the Frenchmen got separated in two groups. One got cornered at the cafe, while the other group managed to avoid getting trapped and is running into the open field. Oh damn, the entire coffee gang got wiped out. About 400 soldiers have been unalived in a matter of seconds. Now the hunt continues, and all of that while Team Red hasn't lost a single warrior. Honestly, I'm pretty confused on why the Frenchmen got so scared, considering they were doing relatively well during the training, but it is what it is. Oh, looks like someone on Team Blue actually managed to get rid of 3 warriors, lol. Now they ran off the map, but the warriors are not giving up on the chase, and soon they engulfed the entire enemy team. Oh well, it seems that the Frenchmen got dominated by all kinds of enemies thrown at them, so I doubt they will be coming back anytime soon. I hope you enjoyed this little weird video, and a huge thanks to my Patreon subscribers Spartan King, Red Nugget, LND Plays, Andrei Svark, Leonard Averitt, and Get Pandon. If you want to support me and get access to exclusive content, check out my Patreon page, link in the description. Meanwhile, check out this other video where Pogo learns to dodge balls. Bye!